And good morning. This is day number 10. And we are in Moab. And we're just having a walk from the campsite down to the central Moab sort of centre, which is, I think we've done about three quarters of an hour, so a couple of miles up to now. It's just basically hotels and a few shops and a lot of eateries. That tends to be what Moab is, but it's lovely. It's nice, nice place. They do cater for a lot of touristy things, so it is like a touristy town. You know, there's lots of trips and bikes to hire and cars to hire, off-roading cars to hire, that type of thing. And again, plenty of motels that you can see here. So it's yeah, it's an interesting town. It's not small. It's a fair bit to go, even though we've been walking for a couple of miles. So it's a fair old way. Anyway, more later. Right, today has not been the best of the days. I think we can probably say it's the worst. Simply because we had a problem with the RV. The what they call the black water pipe. You can imagine why they call it black water, because it's the least clean of all the waters we have. So I'll leave that to your imagination. That broke. Now, how can I describe this? Effectively, we dumped the contents of, yeah, quite a lot of gallons of black water, we shall say, straight onto the ground. I don't know why it hadn't been going out of the waste pipe into the drain. It hadn't. It just must have built up, and eventually it's broken the pipe and it's just dropped everything onto the ground. Right. So I rang up to try and get it fixed. The Cruise America people gave me a garage, but told me I had to get there quick because it was going to be closing soon. I'd started to try and clean up the mess. I'd got a shovel from somewhere and started to clean up. Obviously, I'd only cleaned a little bit of it up before we had to get off on our way. So I took the RV down to the repair place to try and get it repaired. While I was there, when I got there, the guy went, "No, we don't repair them." So that was pretty good. So I got back onto Cruise America, told me another one. I went down to the garage. They're going to see to it at 10 o'clock tomorrow morning. Well, today was always going to be a chill out day, so it didn't matter too much. The problem is when we got back, the guy in the RV next to us apparently went berserk because I'd driven off and left quite a pile of black water, shall we say, the middle of the RV part, our spot. He'd gone, complained, kicked off. Suddenly three buggies had appeared. Guys had come to clean it all up and they were all cleaning it. Now, what the thing is, I told the lady at the camp what I was doing and where I was going and exactly how things lied. But she obviously hadn't told anybody else, so of course they were all cleaning it, thinking I'd just done a runner. The guy next door wasn't happy. First of all, because the smell wasn't pretty. But secondly, when the guy started, and I know this because I've left Jonathan here to sort of explain as well, but when he'd seen this bloke kick off, he just disappeared. But apparently when they were hosing it to clean it all off, it all splattered up the side of his RV. And it's like, oh God. Anyway, so apparently while I was gone, there was absolute pandemonium. So I then rolled back up after being to the garage to sort out getting it fixed, which he can't do it till tomorrow morning, but never mind. And he came back in, and I came back in and met by Jonathan, who was saying, "Look, don't go down there, this guy's gone mental." So I went into the reception, I talked to them. Then it all got squared up that the lady says, "Oh yeah," and she didn't tell the bloke, and anyway, all that rubbish. So I says, "Well, shall I go back to my spot, bearing in mind the neighbour?" They went, yeah, go back to him, he's all right. Well, anyway, I pulled up at the side. And he came out and he was going to get in his car and drive off. So I called him over to talk to him. Anyway, he turned out to be a right nice, right pleasant bloke, and I just explained what had happened, and he just said, oh yeah, that's that noise, by the way, that's those. You can hire those at a place downtown. They cost $600 a day to hire. Anyway, so it all got sorted out. The guy turned out to be not that bad. And everything seems okay now, all sorted. But as you can imagine, yeah, it wasn't pleasant for a bit. But we've still got a broken pipe and can't fix it till tomorrow, so toilet's off use. Which means we need to use it tomorrow. Can't use it till tomorrow till we get it fixed. Anyway, that's the story of that. I did see those jeeps, and I went down and had a look while we had a walk, because we've had a walk into Moab. It's about 2 to 3 miles into the centre, but it was nice to sort of chill out, have a walk, and we haven't done a lot of walking on this holiday. So we had a walk in, a walk round, and then a walk back. But I saw those jeep things, those, there, look, just got into it a bit. And they're quite, where is it, there it is, they're quite good, they look really good, but yeah, $600 a day, plus they want $1,000 deposit, which I suppose you can understand that, you do get that big pack, but still $600 a day to use them, and of course you've got to pay for your own gas, and you've got to either wash them when you come back, or pay another $50 for them to wash it. So it seems quite expensive. So obviously we're not doing that. So that's it. So what we're going to do now is we're just about to go get a swim and finish off chilling. So more updates later. Okay, so final update for tonight. We've had a really sort of chilled back, relaxed day. Apart from obviously the water pipe business, which was a little stressful. But that's all sorted. Well, it's not sorted. It needs to be fixed tomorrow morning. But at least we can go get that sorted tomorrow morning, and then we're on to a place called Chianti, which is in Arizona. Get down there, and then we're sort of in a good vicinity to move on to the Grand Canyon. So it's a bit of a drive day tomorrow. We've sort of got just over 200 miles, but it should be okay, especially after the rest day today, and just chilling and relaxing, which has been nice. So that'll be the final update for today. In the morning we'll say goodbye to this RV park, which has been nice. It's been really nice. It's given us a chance to get a couple of walks in, which we haven't had over really not many walks anyway over these last 2 weeks. So it's been given us a nice chance to get that. So that's it. We'll relax down for the rest of the evening, chill out, get a good night's sleep, and get off early in the morning. Okay, so thanks very much for watching.